Hey guys, I thought I'd do a little bit of a video update of the progress on the boat. The side panel's getting fiberglass together right now on the floor. And over here is the bottom panel. And the way that I glued these together is I super glue the joint or the 2 8-foot panels together, and then I put a layer of fiberglass on the joint, and then I flip the panel over and I put parchment paper down on the bottom, and then I put a layer of fiberglass on the top, and then put parchment paper on top, and then put another board, and then put a heavy weight on it. So
we're glassing together the some of the sides for the Amis right now. I'm trying to glass 4 14-foot long panels together all at one time. So I have wax paper between each layer of fiberglass. It was kind of tricky. Hope it works. That's the Amis. That's the transom piece. The Amis. This goes like right here, sort of. And down below at the bottom are all of the bulkheads with the little stiffeners on them, clamped on them, gluing. Hopefully, we have some Amis here pretty soon. All right, another coat of varnish on the rudder. And the lee board. And there's the cartridge, or whatever you call it. It's going to be painted, probably white. But the rudder and lee board will both be left bare wood. So this works out pretty good doing it this way, and I can get it all done in one night. And that's how all of these joints are glued together. And then we got a shipment in from Duckworks today, which is pretty cool. Always like getting a shipment in from Duckworks, and it's another gallon and a half epoxy kit. I like this brand, and we have 20 yards of fiberglass coming in on a Monday, and then the rudder, I put the last coat of epoxy on the other side of the rudder, and the last coat of epoxy on the other side of the depth finder. And so these are done, those two parts are done, and our Amis are hanging out up here for now, and we'll glass them maybe next weekend. I just wanted to give you guys an update. Thought I'd do a little video update Friday afternoon. Here's the bottom panel and the two bilge panels cut out, ready to get put on this weekend. See all the lines drawn on from all the lofting. The transom. Everything's all leveled and strained. I got all the braces in to hold the width right. Center lined. And on the front, you can't see it, but I had a string coming down here to make sure that the bow is
perfectly straight up and down. And so I guess the next step is flip it over, start putting the bottom panels on. ...800,000 zip ties. It took over an hour to put all these on. Might have to go to the store tomorrow. Get more zip ties. Well, we got our bottom on. We got everything all stitched together. It's looking pretty good. That was a lot of zip ties and a lot of work. I mean, it pretty much took all day. Also put the first coat of paint on the rudder cartridge. It's just hanging out. And that's pretty much it. I was looking at my transom and going, there's a bunch of knots in my plywood transom, but they're only on the outside because if you look inside, there's no knots. I don't know why. Since we're in here, let's see what the inside looks like.
Well, I've made a little bit more progress. We're almost glassed inside, except for this 1 3 or so foot section. I even got at the inside of the bow glass. It was really hard to do that. There's a lot of layers of fiberglass, but you can't really tell. Yep. I need to do the transom and the bulkheads tomorrow, and then I can start putting the inside together. All right, we're fixing the fiberglass today. We've got all three bulkheads. I went ahead and drilled holes like I did in the transom for all the lines and things that would go through, and that'll make a better job. And then over here, we're fixing the glass of transom. It's ready to go. And the last section of the inside of the hull. Last night I did this bow section up here. It was really hard to do. It took like an hour. It's got many, many layers of fiberglass, but you can't really tell. All right, I'll be at it for a couple hours. A little Saturday night video. We got some clampage going on. We're adding the second and last shear clamp. We got some extra bracing in here.
we got the water tray in so that any water that came through the steering ropes and stuff would drain back out of the boat. And also worked on the mast step, which is down in this compartment, along with that mast mock-up that I made. I think it'll work pretty good. Lots of epoxy and lots of fiberglassing and work to do. Never ends. Last part is put in before the decking goes on. That's the sleeve for the mast. And it'll spin in here like this. Kind of mocking up some things. Depth finder. We might use some chairs sort of like this in it. And we can slide back and forth. And one last look at this compartment before it gets covered. Pretty exciting. And start moving along after this.
Mabel Lee, what are you doing, girl?
It's where we're at right now. There's a little video update. The Akas are mounted or bolted to the hull for the first time. We're just working out some of the details. It's coming together. I think that's probably the kind of seat we're going to use. How to add stress to your life. Build a hollow wooden sailboat mast. What a deal. I've just spent the last hour just trying to get it straight. Getting close. We still got a little bit of work to do. Jamming a whitesnake. All right, we got our carbon fiber sleeve over one of our AKA beams. Pulled it tight. Zip tied it down at the end, so there's some kind of tricky stuff to work with. We'll see what happens. Hi guys.
Hi.
Well, I have no idea how fully saturated it is.
Yeah.
See what happens. Well, it's sanded. That was a lot of sanding. My arms are tired. Went through two belts. It's not perfect, but it'll work. Well, we're smoking a turkey this morning. Kind of just getting started. It's a nice day. Working on the boat. Did a little fiberglass work on these AKA beams. Epoxy in the insides of them. Hopefully get the rest of the insides here today. And maybe even fiberglass the other side of the hull today too. Stuff going on over here. Hatch covers need fiberglassed. There's one AKA beam with crooked carbon fiber. That's what we're doing here today. Shop's a mess. There's these things. I sent a picture earlier. They're pretty much dry. Well, we bolted this thing together for the first time today, just to see what it looks like. Mast is pretty tall. You can see now how the AKAs work, and get an idea how big this thing is. Looking pretty good. Hopefully it's fast. Should be. I'm gonna try to do a video on the how it folds. I don't know if I can do it. There it is, folded. Pretty simple. And all right, got the boat's completely fiberglass now. All the way done. Of course, we got to do fill coats and stuff like that. But it's done. The mast has a coat of epoxy on it. So I'm hoping tomorrow maybe to get the carbon fiber on it, and we'll see what happens. And so this is the front hatch and the rear hatch. They're fiberglassed, good to go. AKA beams again. Did something kind of cool. We got the spacers cut for the AKA beam, so they can pivot, which see right here, pivots really nice. That's done. And then in here, everything's a mess. Shop's a mess. All these pieces and parts are just a bunch of things that go on this boat. And here's something that, this is what they do. And they go on the Aka beams like this. So if you look on the end, they're kind of like a saddle for the Aka beams. We'll see what happens. One beautiful wooden mast covered in carbon fiber. I'm spinning it about every 7 minutes right now while the epoxy's wet. Keep it from dripping on the pretty weird. New Year's Day update. We epoxied the bottom of the hatch panels. And also some other pieces and parts that go to the Aka beams and the mast. I'll explain these later. Did another fill coat on the inner Aka beams, so hopefully we'll paint those pretty soon. These pieces and parts are ready to paint. I need to do that here in a little bit. We put a first coat of paint on the Amas on the other side. I did the underside last year. So those things there are coming along. So I do want y'all to understand that this boat is not going to be like a show boat. It's a homemade boat and it's not going to be perfect. So when you see it, it's not going to be Buddy's boat. It's going to have things in it that are just not perfect. I just don't have the time to make a boat like that right now. And so I on purposely bought thick nap rollers to put the paint on with the texture just to cover up things. And then I did the last and final coat on these Aka beams. These are going to be left like this. They're not going to be painted. And so this is the final coat of epoxy on these things. Yeah. I'm tired of working on these. But that's our update. Our New Year's update. Some progress tonight. The inside of the boat. It's got sparkles. Or speckles. A little bit more done. I don't know why these things do this, because there's the doors are shut and everything, but they keep moving around. There's those speckled things. What do we got going on here? I don't know. Weird stuff. We'll see what happens. Okay, well, this is my rig right here to epoxy the mast. Of course, I got a lot of sanding and stuff to do. Pretty cool. quick look tonight at the progress. It's coming along. We put a coat of epoxy on this one little section right here on the mast where the roller was riding right here, and see how that works out. Here's the front hatch in there and some more pieces and parts. Painted the brackets that hold the inner aqua beams on, and one more fill coat on the inner aqua beams, and I'll put one more coat of epoxy on the section where the mast furls, because there'll be a lot of friction here, so I just wanted to make sure there was a good thick coat of epoxy on that section. That's what we're doing tonight. A lot of work today. I just glued the mast step in and I routed the inside of it, so hopefully the mast will go in there easier. It's getting there. The hull's pretty much rigged out. Hopefully it doesn't get too windy. First looks.
There you go.
I think we're gonna go play for a little bit. We got lights. Kind of weird. Trailer's pretty much mostly sorted out. It's kind of a rig, but I think it'll work. Got a new tiller. We're gonna give it a test out before we finish it. Hopefully it works pretty good.